Shadow and Bone is available to watch on Netflix UK and Ireland now. And if you've seen the show but still have questions, this video should help. And if you haven't, pop off, get that sorted before you watch. Massive spoilers incoming. Here are 9 of the most commonly asked questions about season 1 of Shadow and Bone. In any other fiction, you'd simply call them magicians, but the Grisha are more than that. They're capable of controlling the elements on a molecular level, something that's known as the small science in the show's universe. They come from Ravka, a war-torn country inspired by 1800s Tsarist Russia, a place pinned in by their magic-hating neighbors, which also has to contend with the Shadowfold, a vast, monster-filled valley of perpetual darkness that extends from north to south, dividing the country in two. It is, but it's not as simple as you might think. It's based on Leigh Bardugo's best-selling Grishaverse books about a kingdom in turmoil and the magic users who defend it. The bulk of the story in the Netflix adaptation comes from 2012's Shadow and Bone, Bardugo's debut novel and the first book in the Grisha trilogy. But it also incorporates characters from the Six of Crows duology, even though that book technically takes place after the events in Shadow and Bone. Showrunner Eric Heiserer explained that because the books are set chronologically, we technically don't get to events in the Six of Crows series until after Shadow and Bone has ended. To get around this, he and Leigh Bardugo created fresh prequel stories for key Six of Crows characters, such as Kaz, Inej, and Jesper. As Leigh Bardugo puts it, the team built something entirely new while still staying true to the characters and the heart of the stories. The cast is headed up by Jessie May Lee from Last Night in Soho and The West End's All About Eve. She plays Alina, an orphan who discovers she has the power to summon sunlight and potentially change the fate of her kingdom. Archie Renaud from Voyages and Gold Digger plays Maloretsev, Alina's best friend, and Freddie Carter of Pennyworth plays Kaz Brecker, an aspiring criminal with a talent for hatching elaborate schemes. Amita Suman from The Outpost and Doctor Who plays Inej Garfa, a member of Kaz's gang with a troubled past and a unique talent for knife work. And Kit Young from Endeavor is Jesper Fahey, a gambler and sharpshooter who will never walk away from a wager. General Kerrigan, also known in the books as the Darkling, is played by Ben Barnes, previously seen in Westworld and The Punisher. And in fact, enough people have Googled this exact question, we could have given it its own heading. Which leads us to our next question. General Kerrigan leads the Second Army of Ravka, which is made up of his fellow Grisha. He's the most powerful of them all, thanks to his ability to manipulate the shadows. Kerrigan, also known as the Darkling, claims to be descended from the Black Heretic, a fellow shadow summoner who, in an act of jealousy against a rival, inadvertently created the Fold 400 years ago. Legends state that the creation of the Shadow Fold killed the Black Heretic, and no shadow summoner since has been able to undo the damage. But as we eventually discover, none of that is true. Kerrigan is the Black Heretic. Creating the Shadow Fold was no accident, and nor did it kill him. Instead, he faked his own death, and he returns under a different guise every generation.
I made something.
The Shadow Fold, also known as the Unsea, is filled with vicious, flesh-eating monsters known as the Volcra. But what are they, really? The Fold came into existence when the Darkling attempted to create his own army using ancient magic. When his spell went wrong, the humans trapped in the Fold, actually soldiers in the King's army, turned into the winged creatures known in the show as Volcra. This is a valid question, even if it is rather against the spirit of things. But there's a particular reason the Grisha choose to go through the Fold rather than around it. Look at the map of the world and you'll see that Ravka is hemmed in by enemy nations, Fjörda to the north, Shuhan to the south. The Fjördans are Viking-like warriors who live in the mountains and train holy soldiers to hunt Grisha. And the Shu people, famed for their scientific and technological advancements, see the Grisha as little more than guinea pigs to be experimented upon. This last point is also the reason some people mistrust Alina when they discover she's part Shu.
What's a Shu girl doing here?
Compared with running the gauntlet through a shadowy unsea full of feral monsters, it's a rock versus hard place dilemma. The Grisha wield a variety of impressive powers, and thankfully you can tell what they do from the colour and embroidery on their robes, known among the Grisha as kefta. Red kefta are worn by members of the corporalki, and like all Grisha, the colour of the embroidery denotes their specialisation. Heartrenders like Nina, who can control and stop heartbeats, have black embroidery on their kefta, for example. Blue robes are worn by the etherealki, the order of summoners whose power lies in the manipulation of different natural elements. Alina, as a sun summoner, belongs to this class, and her embroidery is gold. The materialki wear purple with grey or red detailing. These are Grisha whose power focuses on composite materials such as metal, glass, textiles, and chemicals. As you might expect, the Darkling with his unique powers is the only one allowed to wear black. Shadow and Bone was filmed in Hungary, partly at Arrigo Studios in Budapest, and also on location in various places in and around the city. It's the perfect foundation on which to build Shadow and Bone's distinct East meets West world. One of the filming locations is Buda Castle, a World Heritage Site and historical palace complex of Hungarian royalty, which was built in the 13th century. The complete history of the stag is probably a video all on its own, but let's try to sum things up here. Alina's powers in Shadow and Bone are regarded as miraculous. She possesses abilities that one day might destroy the fold and reunite Ravka. But even as she's being anointed as a saint, there's growing concern her powers aren't enough. And that's where the stag comes in. It's one of three creatures created by legendary Grisha Ilya Morozova. In the books, Morozova was obsessed with amplifiers, objects such as bones, scales, or teeth that significantly boost a Grisha's power, and the Darkling believes that the bones of the stag would make one of the strongest amplifiers ever crafted, which is why so much time is spent hunting it. Alina and Mal try to track down the stag, but Kerrigan beats them there and kills it, seizing its power and taking control of Alina's abilities. But Alina soon realizes that the stag never chose Kerrigan, it chose her. And while its power alone isn't enough to help her destroy the fold, it does hint at what she needs to do next, since there are two more Morozova animals out there to find. Do you have any more questions about Shadow and Bone? Pop them in the comments below and give this video a like if you enjoyed it. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more videos about your favourite shows and movies.